In this video, I am going to explain you about Johnson counter. This Johnson counter is also known as twisted ring counter. Now we will see the working operation of this Johnson counter. Here, this is the logic diagram of 4-bit Johnson counter. In this, we are going to use D type of flip-flops. Here we are considering 4 binary bits means we have to use 4 D type of flip-flops here. Now, if we see the connection of this 4-bit Johnson counter, here the first flip-flop output is given as input to the second flip-flop. In the same way, second flip-flop output is given to the input of the third flip-flop. And the third flip-flop output is given to the input of the fourth flip-flop. Here, there is small difference between ring counter and Johnson counter. In the ring counter, the output of the last flip-flop Q is given as input to the first flip-flop input. But here, in the Johnson counter, we are going to give the last flip-flop Q complement is given as input to the first flip-flop input. Now, we will see the operation. Here, before applying the clock pulse, we have to clear all the flip-flops outputs. So, by that one, before applying clock pulse, we are going to make Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 outputs are going to be 0 by using clear pin. Now, here, we will apply the clock pulse. Here, this clock pulse is a negative edge triggering type of flip-flops. So, for a transition from 1 to 0, these all the flip-flops are going to be triggered. And here, this clock pulse is connected to all the flip-flops at a time. So, all the flip-flops are going to be triggered at a time. Now, this is the timing sequences of clock pulse. Q1, output of first flip-flop. Q2, output of second flip-flop. Q3, output of third flip-flop. Q4, output of fourth flip-flop. Now, we will see the sequence table here. By applying the first clock pulse, here, before applying clock pulse, the fourth flip-flop output Q4 is 0. So, by that one, complement of Q4 is going to be 1 here. So, by applying the clock pulse, this 1 is going to be fed back to the input of the first flip-flop. By that one, Q1 is going to be 1. We know the truth table of D flip-flop. In the D flip-flop, in the input side, if we give 0 as input, the output is going to be 0. If we give 1, the output is going to be 1 for D type of flip-flop. So, here Q1 is 1. Then, before giving the clock pulse, here Q1 is 0. So, this 0 is given to this second flip-flop input. So, the output Q2 will be 0. And here, this Q2 is given to the third flip-flop input. So, by that one, Q3 will be 0. Then, in the similar manner, Q4 is also 0. Now, by seeing in the waveform pattern, here Q1 is 1, after applying the clock pulse, Q1 is 1, Q2 is 0, Q3 is 0, Q4 is 0. Now, we will apply the second clock pulse. So, by applying the second clock pulse, here, the Q4 is here, 0 means Q4 complement will be 1. So, that 1 is fed back to the first flip-flop input. By that one, Q1 will be 1 here. Then, this 1 is given as input to the second flip-flop means Q2 will be 1. And Q3 is 0 from this Q2. And Q4 is also 0. This is the timing sequence diagram after applying the second clock pulse. Q1 will be 1, Q2 will be 1, Q3 is 0, Q4 is 0. Now, we will apply the third clock pulse. Now, by this Q4, the 0 complement is going to be 1. That 1 is fed back to the Q1. So, first flip-flop input So by that one Q1 will be 1. Then here Q2 will be 1 from the previous output. Here Q3 will be 1. Q4 is also 0. Now by applying 4th clock pulse, here Q4 is 0 means the 0 complement will be 1 that will be fed back to this input of the first flip flop. So D1 is 1 means Q1 will be 1, here Q2 will be 1, Q3 will be 1, Q4 will be 1 here. This is the regarding timing sequence diagram after applying 4th clock pulse. 1, Q2 will be 1, Q3 will be 1, Q4 will be 1. Now if we consider after applying 5th clock pulse, here this Q4 is 1 here. Before 5th clock pulse, Q4 is 1. So Q4 will be 1 means Q4 complement is going to be 0. So this 0 is fed back to this first flip flop input. D1 is 0 means Q1 will be 0. So this Q1 will be 0. So before clock pulse, Q1 is 1. This Q1 is given to the second flip flop input means D2 will be 1 means Q2 will be 1 here. Then here Q3 will be 1, Q4 will be 1. And this regarding diagram, if we see Q1 will be 0, Q2 will be 1, Q3 will be 1 and Q4 will be 1. In a similar manner, we may get other sequences also by applying 6th clock pulse, 7th clock pulse. When we are applying the 8th clock pulse, the sequence we are going to get is Q1 equal to 0, Q2 is 0, Q3 is 0, Q4 is also 0. If we see here, by applying 8th clock pulse, Q1 is 0, Q2 is 0, Q3 is 0, Q4 is also 0. So, for this 4-bit Janssen counter, for every 8 clock pulses, these sequences are going to be repeated. So, this is the working operation of this 4-bit Janssen counter.